Good morning, grade 6 students. How are you all? I hope everyone is fine and staying well. Today is 10th May Sunday and we will be doing the topic identifying the figurative language. The objective of our lesson today is to understand what figurative language is and identify it in a text. Now students, before doing the worksheet on identifying the figurative language from the story, let us do a quick recap on what is figurative languages and also what are the different types of figurative languages are. The first one is simile. As you all know, a simile is a figure of speech that directly compares two things using the words like or as. For example, he is as funny as a monkey. Metaphor. A metaphor is a figure of speech which describes objects or subject as something unlikely and uncommon. For example, the curtain of night fell upon us, and doesn't use the words like or as. Alliteration. In alliteration, series of words begins with the same consonant sound. It means that the consonant sounds are repeated again. Idioms. Idioms are phrases or sayings which we use in everyday language. These phrases or saying don't always make sense literally, but we can still understand what they mean. For example, to let the cat out of the bag. This idiom is not really about letting a cat escape from a bag. It's really about revealing a secret that should have remained a secret. Now students, in this slide, the next figurative language we can see is onomatopoeia. Onomatopoeia is when a word imitates its natural sound or suggests the sound a certain object makes. For example, smash, dripped, crashed. The next figurative language is personification. Personification gives a personal nature or human characteristics to something that is non-human or non-living. For example, the alarm clock yelled at me to get up this morning. We all know that alarm clock is a non-living thing. It cannot shout also, it cannot speak also. But he is comparing the noise, the sound of the alarm clock was so loud as if it is yelling on him, shouting on him. The next figurative language is hyperbole. Hyperbole is a figure of speech which involves an exaggeration of an idea. For example, I am so hungry that I could eat a horse. We all know that we cannot eat a horse. Only he is just trying to exaggerate that he is feeling so hungry that even he could eat a horse. As you all can see, students, in this slide, there are four worksheets. And in these four worksheets, all together, we have four different tasks to do. For example, task A, we have to identify the figurative language. Task B, we have to analyze the figurative language. Task C, we have to modify the figurative language. And task D is to revise the figurative language. Let's start now. Now students, as you can see, this is worksheet number one. And there is task A over here, which says that you have to identify the figurative language. Now, as you all can see, there is a text on Charlie's crocodile escape. I will give you a few minutes time to go through this and then we will do the following questions. I hope everyone has finished reading this text. Now we'll see the question which says that find and underline and label each example of figurative language in the paragraph. Check it on the list as you go. You should find 3 similes, 2 metaphors, 1 hyperbole, 1 personification, 5 alliteration, 1 onomatopoeia, 1 idiom and 1 illusion. Illusion is a figure of speech that references a person, place, thing or event. Now first of all, we will start looking for 3 similes. Now students, read the paragraph again and find out where are the 3 similes over here. Yes, the first simile is he had to be as brave as a lion. This is a simile because the writer is comparing Charlie to a lion, saying he has to be as brave as a lion. he is using the word as. Now students, tell me which is the second simile. Yes, the second simile is no, it smelled like rotting eggs. Why this is a simile? Because the writer is comparing the smell of the river to the smell of the rotting eggs using the word like. I'm sure all of you must have found out the third simile also from the paragraph. We will see that whose answer is correct now. Yes, the third simile is caught a flash of the crocodile's eyes which stood out like menacing tennis balls. Now the writer is comparing the crocodile eyes to menacing tennis balls using the word like. Now students, in this paragraph he will look for two metaphors. Start looking for them. Yes, the first metaphor is he's a bullet. The writer is directly comparing the crocodile to a bullet without using the word as or like. Now students, which is the second metaphor? I hope everyone has found that also. Yes, the second metaphor is Charlie's heart became a robotic hammer. Now the writer is comparing the Charlie's heart to a robotic hammer because without using the words as or like to show how fast his heart was beat. Now students, we have finished with similes also and metaphors. Now the next figurative language which we have to look in the paragraph is one hyperbole. Now who will find this one hyperbole from the paragraph? Yes, one hyperbole is swam at a million kilometers an hour. This is a hyperbole because the writer is exaggerating the crocodile speed as nothing can move as fast as million kilometers an hour. Now students, the next figurative language you have to look for in this paragraph is one personification. Start looking for it. I hope everyone has found one personification also. Yes, Charlie felt fear crawl up his spine. This is a personification as the writer has given the feeling of fear a human characteristics, which is crawling. Now the next figurative language which you have to find it out from this paragraph is five alliteration. Now students, start looking for five alliteration from the paragraph. We will see that who is correct in that. I hope all of you have got the answer. Now the first alliteration is as he tiptoed towards. The letter T is being repeated twice here. However, he had no choice. The letter H is being repeated thrice. Sharp triangular teeth. The letter T is being repeated twice. Crocodile slithered from the lake side and swam. The letter S is being repeated thrice. Was this Wonka's chocolate river? The letter W is being repeated twice. I'm sure students, all of you must have got the correct answers. Now we will move on to the next figurative language which we have to find out from this paragraph. That is one onomatopoeia. Yes, one onomatopoeia is crunch. This is a sound we can imagine made by the sound of skulls getting crushed. Now students, you have to look for one idiom from this paragraph. Find it out. Yes, that idiom is playing with fire. The writer used this idiom to show how much of a dangerous situation Charlie was in. Now the next thing which you have to look in this paragraph is one allusion. Allusion, as I told you, is a figure of speech that references a person, place, thing or event. Now what is this one allusion in the paragraph? Yes, it is, was this Wonka's chocolate river? The writer has used allusion to make an indirect reference to the good smelling chocolate river of Wonka's. Now students, we will move on to the second worksheet. and in which you have the task B, which says to analyze the figurative language. You have to read the story again and then answer the questions. I will give you a few minutes again to read the story again so that we can answer the following questions. I hope everyone has finished reading the story again. Now we will do question number one, which says, in line one, what does the personification tells you about Charlie's situation? Now students, go back to line number one and give the answer that what does the personification tells you about the Charlie's situation? Yes, the personification tells us that Charlie is in a scary situation and he is frightened. Now the next question, students, what does the idiom in line 4 tell you about what Charlie was doing? Go back again to the paragraph, line number 4, and think of the answer that what Charlie was doing. Yes, the idiom tells us that what Charlie was doing was as dangerous or risky as playing with fire. Now we will move on to question number 3, which says, in line 7, which of the following words could best be substituted for the word rotting without changing the meaning of the simile or sentence? Dancing, decaying, decreasing, duck. It means to say that from the following words, you have to choose which word is the best to replace the word rotting without changing the meaning of the simile or sentence. So can you guess what is the answer? Yes, decaying, which means the same as rotting only. Now we will move on to question number 4, which says, in order to understand the allusion in lines 6 to 7, the reader must know someone called Wonka, like chocolate, be familiar with Charlie and the chocolate factory. It means to say that in order to understand the allusion which is given in line number 6 and 7, the reader should know someone called Wonka or like chocolate, or he should be familiar with Charlie and the chocolate factory. What is the answer, students? Yes, the answer is C. He should be familiar with Charlie and the chocolate factory, because the writer is making a reference from that story. Now the last question, question number 5, it says, identify the metaphor at the end of line 11 and write it on the line. So which is the metaphor in line number 11? Yes, the metaphor is, he's a bullet. Now what is the meaning of this metaphor? Can you tell me, students? Yes, it means that the crocodile was as fast as a bullet. Now students, we will move on to worksheet number 3, in which we have a task C, which says that we have to modify the figurative language. So it's written that in task A, you found examples of figurative language in the story. You remember in the task A we found out similes, metaphors, personification. Now you have to choose any 5 of the examples of figurative language and rewrite them using the table below. If you choose a simile, you must write a new simile. Do not change one form of figurative language to another. There are 2 examples in the table to help you. It means to say, students, that you have to choose any 5 figurative language from task A and write them in your own words without changing the type of figurative language. For example, if you choose a simile, then you have to write your own simile similar to the simile in the original story. And there are 2 examples in the table given below which will help you. Now we will move on to the last worksheet. There is task D in this one, which says that you have to revise the figurative language. Now what you have to do, students, in this one, that using the original story from task A and your new figurative language from task C, copy the story, inserting your own examples in place of the originals. Underline or highlight the changes that you have made. In other words, it is asking you to rewrite the above story and replace the figurative language with the ones that you made in task C. That's all for today, students. I hope you enjoyed the lesson and understood it very well. In the same way, you can choose any story of your choice and do the above exercises again. It will help you in identifying the figurative language from the story very well. See you all on Tuesday, 12th of May.